Hello everyone, hello friends, I am Anukta Shivastav. I am a PhD research scholar in computer science department at Valid University, Greater Noida. Okay, so I am here to discuss about zero shot learning, which is very trending topic, or we can say challenging topic in the field of computer science, in the field of research. I am assuming that you all are aware about the basics of deep learning, machine learning, including the supervised and unsupervised learning. When we try to recognize an object in machine learning, we want some level training example. Can you imagine if we don't have the level training example, so can you recognize an object without having level training example? So this is the main question arise.
So now we start about zero shot learning. As we all know about machine learning and deep learning. Machine learning and deep learning both are very trending topic in the field of computer science. Over the last few decades, machines have become much smarter, but without a properly labeled training data of same classes, it cannot distinguish between two similar objects. On the other hand, humans are capable of identifying more than 30,000 basic objects. In machine learning, this is considered as the problem of zero shot learning. Got it? These are some contents related to the zero shot learning. So first one is, what is zero shot learning? Second one is, what is the core idea behind the zero shot learning? Then why we care about zero shot learning? What is the difference between zero shot learning and supervised learning? How to implement zero shot learning? And last one is conclusion. So what is zero shot learning? Zero shot learning refers to the specific use case of machine learning, where you want to classify data based on no labeled examples. Or we can say zero shot learning is used to construct a recognition model for unseen target classes that have not labeled for training. Okay, here are two circles. This one is seen classes. This one represent unseen class. So the knowledge transfer takes place between scenes and unseen class. It takes place from seen class to unseen class because JSL recognition relies on the existence of labeled training set of seen classes and the knowledge about how each unseen class is semantically related to the seen class. Got it? So here the seen class is Y and unseen class is Z. Got it? So the core idea of zero shot learning is to recognize objects whose instance may not have been seen during the training time. There are mainly two objectives of zero shot learning. First is recognize a noble category. And the second one is recognition is done by using metadata relating it to the known categories. Okay. Why we care about zero shot learning? First reason is vast and growing number of categories. So it is difficult to collect and particularly annotating example. And the second one is, as we all know, that new categories always emerge. So it is very difficult to collect the labeled training examples. Some of the examples are object recognition, MRI mind readings. Here we know every annotation is a brain scan. Even every word is a category. So it is very difficult. Here I discussed what is the difference between supervised learning and geo-short learning. In supervised learning, we train data of a class and we want to test data of same class. But in the case of zero-shot learning, there are labeled training examples are not available. So we have to predict about the unseen class, and the figure shows the same thing. So this is the basic difference between zero-shot learning and supervised learning. Okay. According to the Li Jiang's study, zero-shot learning also relies on the existence of a labeled training set of the seen class and unseen class. Both seen and unseen class are related in a high-dimensional space vector that is known as semantic space, where the knowledge from seen class can be transferred to the unseen class. The reason why humans can perform JSL is because of their existing language knowledge base. Let us take an example of zebra and horse, which provide a high level description of new or unseen class, means zebra, and make a connection between it and seen class, means horse. And black and white strips also. So the unseen class is zebra and the seen class is horse and black and white strips. So the knowledge is transferred from horse and strips to recognize a new class, zebra. Okay, got it? How to implement a zero-shot learning? So zero-shot learning utilize the class attribute as a side information and transfer information from source to the unseen class. JSL is done in two stages. First is training and second one is inference. In the training, the knowledge about the attribute is captured. In the inference phase, the knowledge is then used to categorize instance among a new set of classes. Okay? So, some steps involved in the implementation. So, first step is obtain category vector. In order to make JSL effective, the key features are categorized as vector. This means sourcing the specific vector beforehand for the project. Once collected, they are provided with a description which enables the algorithm to classify them accordingly. The second phase is training. The training is done with respect to these vectors, which leads to the classification according to the separate classes. Okay? The last phase is testing phase, which recognizes new inputs and again leads to the newer class regardless of the trained data. So now I will discuss one by one. The first is obtain category vector. So it is done through attributes and word vectors. So by attribute, attribute describes the visual appearance of the concept or instance by assigning labeled visual property to it, and they can be easily transferred from seen class to unseen classes. In the case of word vector, it is a straightforward application to the other data types such as video, text, and audio. Here the figure shows category vectors. Okay. The next phase is training phase. In this phase, we give some known class category vectors v and images x. Learn images by categorizing them as a vector classifier, okay, or regressor. V is equal to fx. And the last phase is testing phase. In testing phase, first of all, we specify vector v for a new class to recognize. After that, map test data fx to category vector space. And at the last, NN matching means neural network matching of vectors and fx. So I think it is all about the basic idea of zero shot learning implementation. Okay. So at last, we can say that zero shot learning method is similar to the human vision system in many ways. Therefore, it can be used in robot vision. Instead of performing recognition on a limited set of objects, using zero shot learning, it is possible to recognize every word object. Yeah. And zero shot learning is a very new area for research, but it is a fact that it has a very high potential and it is one of the leading research topic in computer vision. So thank you.
Hello. So I think it is all about zero shot learning. If you want to know more about zero shot learning or machine learning, you can see my next video, or you can contact to me directly. Contact to me. The link is available below. Hope this video will be help you guys. Okay, thank you.